Hey, everybody. Welcome to another video. Gonna be working on Mike's car a little bit more. So far, since the last video, not much has changed. Welded up this upper radiator pipe. Mike's been making some lines for the turbo. That's the drain. We got a coolant feed here. Got a fitting for the water neck for the coolant return. And got some other fittings for the oil feed for the turbo. This catch can's done making up some lines for it, and welded the dash 8 supply for the power steering pump off the reservoir. So got to make a line for that, but actually I'm taking that to get polished tomorrow. And I also whipped up a quick little catch can for this for the valve cover breathers. So super simple little triangle shaped deal that mounts like right here. Fits pretty good. I'm not going to put it in right now because that's also going to polish tomorrow. But what I'm working on right now is I took Mike's turbo off and I took it apart, and I cut part of the charge pipe off, and I got this Vibrant Cast 90 that I need to weld onto it, and I have it indexed where it needs to go. So I'm just changing over the consumables on the TIG. I got to change over to a ceramic cup and then go ahead and weld this in. And we were thinking about getting this polished, but Mike just doesn't have it in the budget right now, because I'd be like over $100 to polish this thing. And the car's got to go to paint on Wednesday. So, I mean, this is just stuff that I'm trying to like squeeze in before it goes, because I mean, I could be doing all this stuff when the car came back, but I have the time since I'm waiting on some stuff for this. I overnighted some pieces. If you guys didn't see in the last video, this is the airbox I'm building for it that mounts in the hood. But I had to buy an aluminum reducer from 4 to 3.5 inches and a super tight silicone 90 coupler to come off the back of the supercharger. And then this thing should be done tomorrow night, hopefully. I've been sitting on this car for a while and it needs to go. And Glenn also came and dropped off a Raptor today that I got to build a water methanol tank for. So you'll be seeing that this week as well. Super busy week. Super busy week. I gotta finish up the body work on a couple pieces for this car too. Bumpers, fenders, side skirts, hood. Super close on all that stuff though. All the hard shit's done. It's all like the little nitpicky sort of items now. But it's getting pretty late, so I'm gonna try and smash out this compressor housing elbow deal right now, and then get the hell out of here. So I'll do a little time lapse of doing this. Fat ass weave, son. So yeah, because this is 2.5, the outlet on this was like 2 inches. It's a kind of small turbo, but I didn't want to have to adapt from 2 inches up to fucking 3 inches for the intercooler piping. So went ahead with a 2.5 elbow and just threw a big ass weave on it. Turned out pretty sick. Welding down like in that crotch right there and getting it all to like seal up was kind of a bitch, and I dipped the tungsten and then it went bleh, and fucking spat some shit, but that'll clean up nice. I'll wire brush it and it'll look damn good. So yeah, it's like 10 o'clock, I'm tired, and I'm gonna get the fuck out of here. Hopefully by the time I get here tomorrow, all the shit is here for the Challenger. I can finish that and kind of pluck away a little bit more on Mike's stuff and take all the shit to the polisher. But yeah, back tomorrow. All right, so spent a bunch of time running errands today. Spent like 4 hours driving around. Mike's stuff is at the polisher, and I started whipping up the charge pipe. I just have to weld it up. I have the other section right here. Yeah, like that. So super simple. This is actually the piece from the old charge pipe, so I just had to build from there back. This car is still scheduled to go to paint tomorrow. Mike's gonna show up around noon or so to help me load it in the trailer. And then this thing's done. So got the little elbow that I overnighted, finally showed up, made a little bracket to keep it from getting deformed, and the like snorkel sort of thing to positively locate inside of it, and seals up good. Put the front end of this thing back together, looking like a complete car again. And it's pretty late, but I'm gonna go drop this thing off to RPM tonight, and then start working on another vehicle they dropped off. They dropped off a brand new Ford Raptor EcoBoost that I got to build a water methanol tank for. So get started on that this week. And then when this thing's gone, get Kevin's hot rod back in. And yeah, busy, busy week. All right, so today's the day that Mike's car is finally going to go to paint. The Challenger's gone, delivered that last night. Got the trailer hooked up. But Travis's Lexus is in there, so I got to take the SC300 out. And I don't really know where the fuck I'm going to put it. I'm probably going to pull the BMW out of the other unit, park Travis's car in there, because I can't really have his car in here right now because Kevin has been really antsy for me to get on his car. So before this goes, the only thing I want to do is I want to finish up this charge pipe, so then that way we don't have to worry about like shit body stuff getting in there. So I'm going to do that real quick, and then Mike's coming over in a little bit. We'll yank the hood off, blow the car off, make sure everything's good to go, and yeah, I'm excited. Been working towards this day for 2 months now, I'd say, so we're getting there. But yeah, I'm gonna do this intercooler pipe real quick. That's how that goes. Mike just showed up.
What's going on?
We ripped the hood off, so now I'm gonna do the million car shuffle. No, just move the Lexus and the BMW, and then we'll get this in the trailer and we're good to go. Okay, so Mike's car didn't end up going to paint. The painter called us like as we were loading it up and said he wasn't ready, so that kind of sucks. But Mike's car's in the trailer, ready to go. Brought the Speedster body over and pulled in this Ford Raptor that I gotta build a water methanol tank for. But before I start on that, I'm gonna do a little bit on this. Got the roll bar all ready to weld. It's all tacked together. Got my filler rod, and I fixed the water cooler on the new welder setup. I just smashed a new pump in it. Everything seems to be working well. So there's the little flow thing. It's working. The filter pot's all full. And yeah, I'm gonna weld this stuff right now. And I'm also trying out something new. I picked up this titanium cup locally from a shop called 3P. They use these on all their stuff, so I'm gonna give it a shot. It's pretty cheap, and if it doesn't work, it doesn't work. But I decided to get this because that way I don't have to use the ceramic cups on the aluminum. Try and get a little bit better gas coverage on the aluminum, but I'm gonna give it a shot first on this roll bar. Machine's cooking. Okay, well, just shut off. But yeah, welded up pretty good. I think I'll really know if that cup's any good when I go to do some stainless exhaust stuff, because I mean, this is just some mild DOM with the ER80 rod that I cleaned up with a Scotch-Brite. So I mean, but when it's painted, that'll be a good looking bead, and so will that one. But now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to rack the body and then move the cart out of the way and then lower the body down so I could work on that. But I might actually jump on the Raptor now. So the idea with this one is in that corner of the bed right there, they want a water methanol tank that's pretty easily removable, and they want it like 4 to 5 gallon capacity. So I'm going to make it fit that corner really well and kind of come up on the wheel arch. So it'll be about 20 inches long from what I measured. Looks like that'll be good enough. And then I got to make provisions to mount the pump and fittings for the outlet and the float. So I might go ahead and start shearing up some of that aluminum right now and fucking around and see what I can come up with. Okay, so I've been working on this water methanol tank, and here we are. This is what I've gotten so far. Basically just the two sides of the tank. It fits in the truck pretty well, but I have to cut basically where this is, and the pump's going to sit in a relief. So it's going to get walled off here and here, and the pump's going to sit there. This is the side that's going to be visible, so you won't actually be able to see the pump. Went and got a nice Moroso weld-on cap and the fitting for the water outlet. And the other thing is I'm going to have to build a vent for it, and I'm going to have to install the float valve to pop a light when the thing gets low. But I don't know what it is, man. Today I am just not feeling it. I'm just so out of it. So what I might do is I might weld on this thing for a little bit, do a little bit of MIG welding action, some squirt gun stuff. This side of the floor is all welded. I need to do that side of the floor and then weld all of the tunnel and the back side of the firewall. And then once that's done, I got templates for the sides. I can maybe start whipping up the side panels or continue on the roll bar. I don't know, but I'll probably just MIG for a little while on this, get back in the groove, and then jump back on that water methanol tank. So, yep, move this machine, get the MIG welder out, and start burning some stuff with the squirt gun. Got most of the welding done on the speedster. It's all welded along the side of the tunnel and along the side of the body. The top side of the tunnel is all welded. Kind of just did like a real quick poopy weld on that because it's all going to get weld ground and there's going to be an aluminum cap. Cleaned up all my rosette welds, and basically all I have left is to weld the back section in here. And I also got to trim the excess of the tunnel here, or the firewall, and then I'm going to weld and blend in this corner weld edge to edge like I still need to do this one. That needs to be blended in. But, you know, put a couple hours in on this. Pretty stoked on it so far. And I've just been chipping away at this water methanol tank. Got all the pieces pretty much where they need to go. This radius piece was kind of a challenge because it's not a consistent radius. Like, it's a lot flatter here and then it tightens up down here. But I got that tacked in there. Got this all walled off. That's where the pump's going to sit. Where is that pump? There it is. So that's going to sit there. Got this piece cut up. This is going to be my overlay panel, like I did on the last water methanol tank. And I went ahead and started welding up a little bit of this. But I think right now I'm going to actually weld this container up. You're probably wondering why I still have the plastic on. I leave as much plastic on as I can, so then that way when I'm moving it around on the table, it doesn't get scratched up. The other side is going to be the visible side, and I still have the plastic on there. So I just want to keep it nice. I actually took a lot of time picking out this one sheet of aluminum because they had a bunch that had some pretty serious scratches in them, but this was the nicest one, so I'd prefer to keep it that way.
I got a story.
been thrashing away on this thing, getting pretty close to being finished, but got the cover panel put on it. Turned out pretty damn good. DA'd it. Just finished welding on the two mount studs on the bottom. And the outlet port, 3/8 MPT outlet port, and then drilling the holes to mount the pump. Pretty stoked on how this thing is coming out. But basically, those studs are going to sit in this bushing. It's probably hot. I don't want to melt it. But yeah, something like that. And then these are going to get fit into that piece of aluminum. So those will drop down into that piece of aluminum. And then I got to just figure out a top mount. I took the bed cap off and it broke. So I'm going to have to replace that, unfortunately. But yeah, getting pretty close to this thing. So I got to finish this thing by tomorrow because I'm not going to be here Sunday. Sunday there's a drift event and Chelsea DeNofa is actually coming here and coming to one of our local tracks, Colorado National Speedway. He's putting on like a learner's day clinic thing. And Avery with the Turbo E36 that was here in one of the last videos, he's actually participating in it. So I'm going to go watch and hang out with Avery and just hang out and have a good time. Take a Sunday off for once. That'll be nice. So kind of thrashing to try and get this done because I know they want to deliver this. This guy's kind of getting impatient. So yeah, getting close. I might do a little bit more tonight. Maybe not. I don't know. We'll see. Water methanol tank's all done. Got the lower mount with the isolators and then a mount there. And then two mounts up at the front. It's all cleaned up. Pump's mounted. The line is plumbed from the tank to the pump. And basically it's done. So I'll show you up close. This is the vent, just a one touch fitting down. It's actually bored to like an eighth inch on the inside. So it just has a little tiny hole to breathe out of. But I think that looks pretty good. Mount turned out pretty nice. And took Mike's car to paint today finally. So it's at the paint shop. Painter said by the end of the month. That's a little over a week away. Don't know if I believe that or not. I sure hope it's done by the end of the month, but we'll see. It's I'm excited to see that thing come back. I gotta finish out the last couple body parts for it, but I should have those done by Tuesday or Wednesday, so a couple days. Still gotta work on the speedster and stuff, but I'm gonna end this video here. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed the water methanol tank and a little bit of Mike's car. So yeah, see you guys next week.